So the marshmallow theory is, it's a well-known and apparently the most dominant theory in psychology and psychoanalysis and so forth. And it's basically that they said, the test is you take one marshmallow and you put it in a room and you put two kids in there. And you know, basically toddlers, you know, young kids. And you tell them, do not touch that marshmallow. Well, the test showed that the majority of at least 50% of the time, there was always one kid that took the marshmallow. And from that study, they derived and conceived the idea that, well, then that was an indication of a troubled childhood ahead. The one who took the marshmallow, the one who didn't take the marshmallow, was considered to be the more normal and the more expected of what you would see. So, based on that, they did the whole thing with that output, and they said, well, if somebody takes a risk and does that and they're a toddler, does that indicate, what does that indicate?
Well, selfless one thing, little bastard.
Yes, yeah, a hungry little kid that ain't getting enough of his shit.
I've seen the video of that test. They did it somewhere on TV. Mm-hmm. And they're like, and if you don't touch it, you get two more instead, you know? Mm-hmm. So it's like testing them. Some of them are like, I want it now, like Veruca Salt and Willy Wonka. But,
Well, the whole idea is that the indication of if the one kid took it, then that kid's going to be trouble up ahead.
Yeah, it's a little bastard.
Said, well, because it ties into this whole ADHD thing. There's a whole other study about ADHD and the scrambledness of, you know, not having enough attention, which kind of ties back into this. But let me finish the marshmallow theory first. So what they're saying is, once you take it, keep an eye on those guys. They're going to cause trouble. Well,
start a file.
I was just reading it. It says the studies found that children who were able to resist the marshmallow were more likely to have higher SAT scores and fewer behavioral problems.
Yeah, they got their shit in line.
Yeah, so how about that, right? So then somebody said, well, what if that was either Trump or Elon in a study like that as children? And do you have any doubt that both of those would be one of the kids who took the marshmallow? Yes. Because why? Because they are risk takers. And you don't get people getting things done who are not aggressive and go after shit. So what they're realizing is they got the study wrong. The people that go after it are the ones you want to watch on and you want to nurture and see what they do, because they're the risk takers. Totally different perspective than they have had for a while. So that's one. So now tying it to the ADHD, they're saying that, you know, there's now new study says that ADHD is a phenomic. It's something that happens within your genes. And they looked at it a little further and they said, well, yeah, but there's some other indications going on here. If you look at people who have this attention problem and they're all fluttering about and trying to do this, that, and too many things at once and then confused by it, it's because they have an aggressive or a proactive nature. They're always scanning stuff. Most likely, they would have made excellent hunter-gatherers back in the day because they're the ones that are always paying attention. And that the ADHD problem that we're seeing is the suppression of that natural ability, that innate, what even genetic component of that's how their nature is. So now people are going, well, wait a minute, maybe it is we're caging up too many of these people for the wrong reasons. Maybe we're looking at them from an old lens that is just, it's out of focus and it's dirty. You need to clean that shit off. So I think we're going to keep seeing more and more of that kind of shit.